we used to watch a lot of Channel Awesome when we were in university, and that's something that was very formative to us, but at the same time, with things coming out this past year, it's kind of upsetting. But the Nostalgia Critic did this review on this movie called The Room, and we had never heard of it, and we had actually thought that The Room was just some kind of, like, elaborate joke that he made.
The Room became something absolutely crazy for us because it was something that we had gotten from the internet, but we had somehow, like, inserted it into our life by going to see, like, actual, like, cult kind of screenings of The Room, very reminiscent of Rocky Horror, where people are, like, throwing things at the screen and there's stuff that you're supposed to show. And it was fun, it was great. There was no sense watching it alone. And then we've got The Disaster Artist, which was even better in a way because it tells you that The Room is fucking nuts. But you know what? Real life can be crazier.
Greg Sestero wrote a book about his time with Tommy Wiseau and filming The Room, and that book became just like, we were obsessed with it because how could this be real? And whenever I think about it, I always think about the bit where he found the zodiac sign drawn on Tommy Wiseau's car and he's like, I just liked the symbol.
And it has become one of the hallmarks of our, like, of this niche we love, which is, like, disaster productions. After watching the movie, it just cemented everything for us.
What The Disaster Artist the movie taught me was you can turn anything into a horror movie. Like, they filmed this comedy like a horror movie, and goddamn, it was an amazing movie, but I am never gonna be able to watch it again because I was uncomfortable the entire time.
It was quite interesting, that choice, and it was like, it was a great choice, but like, man, was it uncomfortable even when it was funny. You can't write this.
You can't make this shit up.
It's too out there. And I think we have read a few books that almost try and hit that level, but they always feel fake when something like this is just have been out there and it's absolutely real.
So, of course, I think my other favorite Tommy Wiseau story, which I will share with you now, was once upon a time I realized that Tommy Wiseau had an online store. And Tommy Wiseau had a sale on his online store. And it was almost Chelsea's birthday. Well, Chelsea's birthday was 2 months away, and I figured this was enough time. So what I decided to do was I ordered Chelsea Tommy Wiseau branded, like, highlighter yellow underwear. And I figured 2 months was enough time. But it wasn't. It was late. And one day, Justin, I received this package in the mail, and Tommy was so, I guess he felt bad that his package was like 2.5 months late, so he sent me a signed photo of him. It sits on my dresser framed, and for me, it's a reminder that if you are motivated and dedicated and just crazy enough, even you can make your dreams come true.
The one joy I think we've really gotten out of The Disaster Artist, the book, / the movie, / The Room, is bringing other people to see it. We have friends who still talk about it. I got my cousin involved, and then she ended up, like, dragging me to a thing where they screened The Room and Tommy Wiseau was actually there. Seeing Tommy Wiseau in real life was incredible because he looks exactly like he looks on screen, except he wears a whole lot more belts. Like, lots of belts. Kingdom Hearts has nothing on the level.
Is it Kingdom Hearts level belts?
More. More belts. Just all around his waist. So, he is just as weird in real life. In case you were wondering. Woohoo!